cost per busser. And today, as a part of a term paper, we are going to present this presentation on bottom-up parsing by me and Devarathi Bhattacharya. Now, what is parsing? Syntax analysis is also called parsing. It takes the token produced by lexical analysis as input and generates a parse tree, which is also known as syntax tree. In this phase, token arrangements are checked against the source code grammar. That is, the parser checks if the expressions which are made by the tokens are syntactically correct. Now, syntax analyzers follow production rules defined by means of context-free grammar. The way the production rules are implemented divides parsing into two types. That is, we have a top-down parsing and we also have a bottom-up parsing. Now, what is bottom-up parsing? So, as the name suggests, bottom-up parsing starts with the input symbols and tries to construct the parse tree in a bottom-up manner to the start symbol. So, the bottom-up parsing is also known as the shift-reduced parsing. Bottom-up parsing is used to construct a parse tree for an input stream. In the bottom-up parsing, the parsing starts with the input symbol and constructs the parse tree up to the start symbol by tracing out the rightmost derivation of the stream in reverse order. So, now we have an example over here. Now, let's see the example. We have an input string id plus id into id. The production rules are as follows. That is, s produces e. E produces E plus T, E produces E into T, E produces T, and E produces ID. So let us look at the solution. First, we have the input string as follows. Now, from that, using the fifth production rule, we replace the ID with T. Then, using the fourth reproduction rules, we again further break down that input string. Using the fifth production rule, we again further break it down into E plus T into ID. Then, using the second production rule, we break it down. Using the fifth production rule, we are again breaking down. Finally, we get the S string. Now, types of bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing starts from leaf nodes of a tree and work in upward direction till it reaches the root node. Here, we start from a sentence and then apply production rules in the reverse manner in order to reach the start symbol. The image given below depicts the bottom-up parsers that are available. So, as we can see from the image that is given below, the types of bottom-up parsers that the compiler uses. Now, what is shift-reduced parsing? Shift-reduced parsing uses two techniques for bottom-up parsing. These steps are known as shift step and reduce step. Now, what are these? In the shift step, the shift step refers to the advancement of an input pointer to the next input symbol, which is called the shifted symbol. This symbol is pushed onto the stack. The shifted symbol is treated as a single node of the parse tree. Next, we have the reduce step. What does it mean? When the parser finds a complete grammar rule, RHS, and replaces it with LHS, it is known as reduce step. This occurs when the top of the stack contains a handle. To reduce, a pop function is performed on the stack, which pops up the handle and replaces it with the LHS non-terminal symbol. Now, let us look at the following example. So, we have a very simple example over here. We have the production rules given as follows. S produces S plus S, S produces S star S, and S produces ID. So, for example, we are asked to perform the shift-reduce parsing over here of a given input string, which is ID plus ID plus ID. As you can clearly see from the solution, first, initially the stack is empty. Then, we have the input buffer, that is, we have the input string, which is ID plus ID plus ID. Then, we have the action. So, first, we shift it. We post the first element to the stack ID, then we reduce the input buffer, then we perform the reduce option by replacing it with the grammar production rule that is ever given. For example, over here you can see that the S is reduced to ID by using the production rule number 3. Similarly, we take an element from the input buffer, we post it into the stack, and we reduce that elements in the stack using the production rule. And by continuing this process, we finally reach when the entire stream gets accepted. So over here, the entire stream gets accepted, and we finally have the input stream, that is S. So following on, LR parser. The LR parser is a non-recursive shift-reduce bottom-up parser. It uses a wide class of context-free grammar, which makes it the most efficient syntax analysis technique. LR parsers are also known as LRK parsers, where L stands for left-to-right scanning of the input string, R stands for construction of rightmost derivation in reverse, and K denotes number of look-ahead symbol to make decisions. Now, there are three widely used algorithms in LR parser. That is, we have first the SLR, then the LR, then the LLR. Now, what does it mean? In the SLR, that is SLR1, that is a simple LR, works on the smallest class of grammar, few number of states, hence very small table is used in this algorithm. It is very fast and simple. Next, we have LR1 parser, that is the LR parser, also known as the canonical LR parser, works on complete set of LR grammar, generates large table, large number of states, and its construction is slow. The next, moving on, we have the LLR parser, that is known as look ahead LR parser, works on intermediate size of grammars and number of states over here is same as that of SLR. Now we have the LR parser model. LR parser consists of an input and output, a stack, a driver program, and a parsing table that has two functions. One is action and go to. The driver program is same for all LR parsers. Only the parsing table changes from one parser to another. The parsing program reads character from an input buffer one at a time, where a shift reduce parser would shift a symbol, and LR parser shifts a state. Each state summarizes the information contained in the stack. The stack holds a sequence of states, so S1 to SM, where SM is on the top. So here we have the image how this LR parser works. This is the complete model of the LR parser. Now we have some gate questions which will be
So question number one, which is what is the similarity between LR, LLR and SLR? We have four options. Option A, use same algorithm but different parsing table. Option B, same parsing table but different algorithm. Option C, their parsing tables and algorithm are similar but uses top-down approach. Option D, both parsing tables and algorithms are different. So the correct option is option A, which is use same algorithm but different parsing table. And the explanation for this is the common grounds of these three parsers is the algorithm, which is the driving program is same for all the LR parsers, but their parsing table is different. Moving on to the next question, we have a bottom-up parser generates. Again, we have four options, which are rightmost derivation in reverse, leftmost derivation and leftmost derivation in reverse. The correct option will be option B, which is rightmost derivation in reverse. And the explanation for this is, as we know that LR parser is a non-recursive shift-reduced bottom-up parser. And these parsers are also known as LRK parsers, where L stands for left to right scanning of the input stream. R stands for the construction of rightmost derivation in reverse. And K denotes the number of look-ahead symbols to make decisions. Then the next question is, which of these is true about LR parsing? Option A is most general non-backtracking shift-reduced parsing. Option B, it is still efficient. Option C is most general non-backtracking shift-reduced parsing and it is still efficient. Option D is none of the mentioned. The correct option will be option C, which is most general non-backtracking shift-reduced parsing and it is still efficient. It is because LR parsers are a type of bottom-up parsers which efficiently handle the deterministic context-free languages in guaranteed linear time. The next question is, if a state does not know whether it will make a shift operation or reduction for a terminal is called. Option A is shift-reduce conflict. Option B is reduce-shift conflict. Option C is shift conflict. Option D is reduce conflict. And the correct option is option A, which is shift reduce conflict. As the name suggests that the conflict is between shift and reduce, so it is called the shift reduce conflict. Then the question is, when there is a reduce conflict, we again have four options, which is option A. If a state does not know whether it will make a shift operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal. Option B. If a state does not know whether it will make a shift or reduction operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal. Option C is if a state does not know whether it will make a reduction operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal. Option D is none of them mentioned. So here the correct option is option C, That is, if a state does not know whether it will make a production operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal, the explanation for this is it occurs when if a state does not know whether it will make a reduction operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal. So these were all the previous year gate questions, and with this we come to the end of our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Kaustav and Devarathi. Excellent presentation. But
thank
one,
you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, but one thing I must mention that you have omitted LR0. That is the basic thing. So after shift reduce, Kaustav, Devarathi, are you understanding?
And yes, sir.
It is. I also not covered in detail. I wish to cover right now. So it is basically after shift reduce, then comes LR0. LR0 is basically Kaustav has said correctly. It is a state, not only the symbol, input symbol and state. And somewhere in the last video I mentioned, in my video I say actual implementation, the state is only stacked, not the symbol. But sometimes it is easiest to be understood that in the stack, the symbol that is from input and the state, both can be embedded. So push can be done pair at a time, pop should be an pair at a time. The first you have to make LR0 parsing table, then the how to create the parsing table, that is, so are you getting the first is LR0, then whenever first is shift reduce, the problem of shift reduce is the when the conflict is shift reduce or reduce, there is no such conflict shift, okay. So sometimes reduce conflict or shift reduce conflict, you need to have a look ahead, okay, in look ahead of one token, then the LR1 is the best parsing algorithm. But LR0 doesn't look ahead, it just see the top of the stack, the whole information of the stack is at the stack state, okay. Initially you load it S0 and then at the finally there should be S1, that is when the start symbol is there, and whenever you see the top of the stack, and then the parsing table, that is interesting. What is the action table? Action table means you have can be four actions, shift reduce and either shift or reduce, not sorry, either shift or reduce, accept or error. Any entry is not there, that is error. Now, what is the go-to section? Go-to section is for the variable. So, whenever you are making a state, you see the handle at the top of the thing, at the stack and stack state, then you reduce it by that production rule. And the production should left hand side, remember, is always the variable comes. And when the variable comes, then from the variable, you go to the fire the rule number. Okay. In the variable, the action you give either S3, that means you shift by rule 3, or R3, reduce by R2, R by reduce rule number 2, or accept ACC or blank. Okay, and now on the go to you have the variable, you have only the state number. So whenever the variable you reduce it, then the variable at the top of the stack, and the top will be the state number. Okay, so and you have to pop it. If they reduce it, say either function variable is say capital A reduced to small b small c, so you have to take 4. So that terminal 4 state C, sorry, at least 4. So because your right hand side of the rule is 2 variable, so you have to pop 4 because state and the variable, and then you push the state number. Okay, so this is it. It is very interesting. And then the LR0 means it is like a Gandhari, you cannot look ahead one. Then whenever you give LR1, it is because you are seeing the top of the stack state and the input symbol, then it will be much easier to reduce conflict or shift reduce conflict. So LR1 is the most powerful, but the problem is your parsing table will be huge, so compromise will be LR1, then the more SLR, but best is LR1, and LLR is very good. So your presentation is excellent. Only thing, missing is that portion, that is LR0.
LR0.
Because LR0 is historically very important. You cannot, you first have to understand the bottom-up parsing by shift reduce, in the shift reduce parser, but shift reduce, remember only terminal and variable into the stack, but no state. Then LR0 gives the concept of terminal and state. And then the table of the action table, either shift, reduce, accept or blank error, and the right hand side go to means your for variable. Okay, that's it. Have you understood? You